Okay, so good news. I got a lot of stuff done today. I got a phone number for a sober living place, and they do have a bed, but they drug test on the regular. So if they find me dirty with alcohol, they kick me out. But this is the place. Right there. Yeah, it's San Pedro, California. So I'm getting stuff done. I'm being proactive. This is difficult, but I think I got something here. I have a lot written down for the book, and I've gotten the suicidal thoughts out of my head thus far. I think I got this, guys. It's it ain't no thing but a chicken wing. Anyway, gotta get back in my home. Currently living out of my car, but that's the new norm, right? Ooh. Man, my place is a mess. It's not that bad. It's not that bad because there's worse. There's people that are really, really messy. Took my medication. I've been very negligent with my health. That's one thing that this drug does. It makes you very negligent with things that are important. Your health, your teeth, your family, your job, everything. You pretty much give up everything. But see, in my case was different because everything was already lost. So, you know, it wasn't the other way around. Later I'll go more in detail about what this drug does, but it's not mainly the drug, it's the person, and it's their mental, the way they were, their upbringing was. People with that have stresses when they were young, they're most likely to use addictive personality, trouble with relationships, that sort of thing. We become codependent, and that's not fair to the person, because a person that loves you they don't have to make you happy. A person should be with you because they want to be with you, but they don't need you in the least. They choose to be with you because they like you. They don't have to be with you. That was something that I had very hard time understanding. And until I get better, until I learn how to love myself, I will not find anyone that would want to be with me. Because if I can't love myself, I can't love anyone else. I have to love myself enough not to get into toxic relationships. I have to love myself enough to not just go for the injured gazelle. I have to love myself enough to say no. I want someone that's quality. I want someone that's up to par with me. I want someone at my mental level. I just don't want to, you know, well, yeah, maybe I do just want to bang. But that's besides the point. You want to be with someone that has, you know, substance. Not just, you know, having sex. Because that gets old. What do you do afterwards? You know, got to have something to talk about, right? You wanna take some person out, you know, for drinks, cocktails, whatever. Maybe that's not your thing. Doesn't matter. For me, it is. I want to be like, damn, you know, that's, she is way too good for me. I want to be able to say that. I don't want to be like, well, you know, it's all I can find. That's horrible. The relationship should be the last thing on my mind. I need to worry about me. I got to get my head straight, because I cannot be in any kind of relationship whatsoever. I shouldn't even be jerking off. I'm going to edit that one out, I promise. I'm hungry. Why am I wearing army gear? I haven't done laundry. I can't afford it. Not gonna cry. Not gonna cry. Not gonna cry. Not gonna cry. Not gonna do it. Okay. I'm gonna talk to you guys. Keep you posted and see what's going on in my journey. And hopefully, through my experience, I could help others. Because that's what I really love deep down inside. Because I had money. I had a home. I had a bunch of toys. And people that know me, the game room and all the reviews and all that, I couldn't care less. I mean, yeah, I do love video games, but I spent way too much time and energy on things that don't really make you happy. They're just superficial moments of joy that don't last very long. So you got a rare comic book or a rare game collectible, and it sits there and it collects dust. And meanwhile, I could have been engaging more with my kids. That would have been priceless. Yeah. Gotta go.